So you have a GoPro and maybe you watched our other video on how to get started with it. What's next? I'm Trisha Hershberger and you are watching DIY in 5. And today we're gonna go over the different video settings on a GoPro, what they mean, and how they can affect your shots. Resolution is probably the easiest setting to understand thanks to things like HDTVs. By default, your GoPro should be set up to shoot in 1080p and will look great if you play it back on your computer screen or your big screen. But what about all those other resolution settings? Many people believe that more is better when it comes to the number of pixels, but is that really true? Now, if you're a professional video editor, then yes. You can do a lot more with your video when you have more pixels. But if you're just starting out, then shooting in 4K probably won't benefit you. In fact, you'll just end up running out of storage space faster. Womp womp. For instance, if you're shooting in 4K, you'll probably get around 80 minutes of footage on a 32GB card. If you shoot in 1080p, you should get over double that with the same size card. We'll put a link in the description below to our storage chart. It'll give you an idea of how much storage you need based on how much you want to shoot. Next, we'll talk about frame rates. If you're brand new to video, this might not make any sense, but don't worry because frame rates are really easy to understand once you break it down. Most everything you watch, whether it's online, on TV, or at the movies, is viewed in 24 to 30 frames per second. GoPro's default setting shoots much faster than that, 60 frames per second, or FPS. Why does it shoot at higher FPS? The higher frame rates allow you to play back your footage slower and give you that really cool slow motion look. Depending on which GoPro you get, you can shoot at up to 240 frames per second. So be sure to choose the best FPS for whatever action you're into. Besides its small size and ruggedness, one of the best things about the GoPro is the lens. The GoPro has the ability to give your footage a cinematic DSLR type look or a really cool action camera fisheye feel, all using the same lens. Here we'll show you the same shots using each of GoPro's different lens settings in 1080p mode. The narrow setting is similar to a DSLR type shot. It's ideal for all the non-action video that you'll take. The medium lens setting still has a slight fisheye wide angle look, but the subject will look closer to the camera. Super view is a setting unique to GoPro. The shot is similar to standard ultra wide, but shows a bit more on top and bottom and stretches the side of the footage to fill the screen. Pro tip, don't use this setting if you have important subjects on the side of the frame because they will get stretched out. Ultra wide gives you the widest angle view and is the signature GoPro look. It's awesome for capturing action footage because it shows more of the scene. Now, it's important to note that GoPro doesn't offer all those settings for each different resolution, so be sure to pick the resolution that works best with the view that you want. Once you're comfortable with the settings we've already discussed, we can move on to white balance. White balance can really make your footage look more professional and gives viewers a better experience. If you're just starting out, there's an auto white balance setting that works great. It automatically adjusts the color tone based on the environment you're in. Now, if you want to get more adventurous, you can try shooting with some of the other settings. Use 3000K for warm light, like incandescent or sunrise and sunsets. Try 5500K for slightly cool light, like cool fluorescent or average daylight. And you can set it to 6500K for cooler light situations like overcast weather. The last thing we'll discuss in this video is Protune. You may have seen this setting in the photo and video options. Protune gives professional editors files they can do lots of cool stuff with, and that's awesome, but there's relatively little benefit to the average GoPro user. Trust me on this one. Now go make some awesome GoPro videos and share them with us at Kingston Tech on Twitter, or tell us your own tips in the comments section below. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already, and check out our other awesome videos that you can find on this channel. Thank you so much for watching DIY in 5. My name's Trisha Hershberger, and I'll see you next time with more tech tips.